Hello, my name is Philip Deal, and it is my honor today to welcome you to the Spring 2020 Convocation. Having earned my Ph.D. from the School of Civil Engineering and Environmental Science, I represent both the Graduate College and the Gallogly College of Engineering. On behalf of my fellow graduates, thank you to all the family and friends that have come to join us today and share in the celebration. Now, it is my honor to welcome the Associate Dean of Academic Affairs, Dr. Randa Shehab.
Welcome to the 2020 Convocation of the Gallogly College of Engineering. I'm Randa Shehab, Associate Dean of the College, and on behalf of the faculty and staff, we are proud to share this moment with you. Today is the day we celebrate the hard work, dedication, and accomplishments of our graduates. Although we cannot be together to share in this celebration, we are thankful for the ability to commemorate this event with a virtual ceremony. Education is a journey. One that takes planning, commitment, and perseverance. Do you recall when your journey started? Many of you started planning your journey in high school. You decided to take math and science classes, and you participated in organizations that prepared you to be a young adult and a leader. You took the ACT or the SAT, probably several times, trying to improve your chances of getting admitted to a good college and getting scholarships. You applied to one or many colleges, you waited patiently for the results, you celebrated admissions, and then faced perhaps the most difficult decision of your life up to that point in time, where to go to school and what major to pursue. Some of you knew immediately that you wanted to be an OU engineer and were excited to come to campus. Others of you may have struggled more with the decisions and felt anxious when you decided to join OU. But each of you chose to continue your educational journey with the Gallogly College of Engineering. While your journeys all have shared goals, we recognize that each of you took your own path. Some of you came directly from high school and were immediately part of communities such as Camp Crimson, AT&T Summer Bridge, the Honors College, or Women in Engineering. Others of you came after completing courses and/or degrees elsewhere, and you had to find and develop new communities through organizations such as the programming team, the Sooner Off-Road team, the AME graduate student community, or through research groups with faculty. These communities helped you adapt to campus life. They gave you the opportunity to practice hands-on engineering. They engaged you in shaping the curriculum and policies that govern your major. For each of you, this has been a multi-year journey that demanded a commitment to hard work, a commitment to studying and research, and a commitment to carry on when you felt the most frustrated. And while your educational journey may have felt lonely at times, the communities you were part of at OU provided friendships to travel with you on your journey. They provided emotional and academic nourishment when the journey was tough. They persisted along with you to share the accomplishments we are here to celebrate today. These communities also shaped the way you engage, solve problems, and lead. Their influence will be with you throughout your life, and they will shape the legacy that you leave as an OU engineer. As your journey as an OU engineer comes to a close, we want to invite you to share in the reflections of one of your engineering peers. The senior speech is a Gallogly College of Engineering tradition where one graduating student is selected to share their story. Particularly during this time of learn anywhere and work anywhere, we feel it is important to have a student voice in our graduation celebration, a voice that can bring to mind the communities that traveled with you on your journey. We hope that this student message helps you remember that you are part of many OU communities, including OU Engineering. This year, Christina Lee will present the senior speech. Christina is a graduating senior in the School of Aerospace and Mechanical Engineering from Oklahoma City.
Welcome, distinguished guests and faculty, family and friends, and of course, the graduating class of 2020. Let me start by saying that I am sorry. I'm sorry our senior year didn't turn out the way we planned. I'm sorry our final projects were transformed or canceled in a matter of days. And I'm so sorry that our final goodbyes were said without knowing they were our last. It wasn't supposed to end like this, but it did. These are difficult times, and we are facing a problem like never before. Unfortunately, there is no back of the book to turn to for solutions. My stepfather had a motto, and it stuck with me since his passing: victory through tenacious perseverance. For him, getting through life wasn't just about pushing through obstacles to the other side. Instead, It was about enjoying the journey for all its ups and downs, cracking a joke about it, and appreciating the challenge because it made him into a better man. Seniors, we will get through this and all that is to come. We have persevered through this degree. We knew it would be difficult, and we did it anyway. We have spent sleepless nights studying an EQUAD. We have designed, programmed, conducted labs, and have built some incredible things. We've worked together, cried together, and celebrated at O'Connell's together. I am so proud of all we have accomplished. We did it. You did it. We have emerged as intelligent and capable engineers. We are the engineers who push research and design beyond what we thought possible. We are the engineers who step up to help their communities. We are the engineers who create solutions for our world. This graduation is our first taste of victory, but this will not be the last of our troubles. We will face hardship, failure, and loss. But when that happens, we must persevere today and every day. So seniors, continue to persevere with a smile on your face, with a helping hand, and with the sooner spirit we all carry within us. Because I promise you, the best is yet to come. Thank you.
This is Dr. Sean Emerson Simmons, Chairman of the Gallogly College of Engineering, Dean's Advisory Board on Diversity and Inclusion. On behalf of the board, I want to congratulate all our graduating students. This year is different, and maybe for some of you, disappointing, but it shouldn't be. You have a story of resilience that you will always be able to draw energy from. You chose a challenging major. You made it past the weed-out courses. And though we won't be having graduation in person, you will graduate despite COVID-19. You are a problem solver and will go on to tackle the world's toughest challenges, but that's nothing for you. Now, go be great, and don't forget to reach back and give back. You did it, and every member of DABD joins me in being proud of your accomplishments. Again, congratulations. Oh, and Boomer!
Sooner!
Graduates, the Landers family sends greetings and well wishes from our home in Tulsa Midtown, where we are together as three generations of family. Though I am retired from OU, I'm still an educator with the privilege of tutoring our grandchildren after Tulsa Public Schools dismissed early. With the spare time at home, we've turned the backyard into a victory garden. I am deeply grateful to have served as dean during your academic life in the OU Gallogly College of Engineering. As I have often said, there is never a better time than now to be an engineer. At OU, the faculty and staff have well prepared you to make this a better world. Ours is a scientific, technical, entrepreneurial, and global profession. While we can continue to adapt, reflect, and overcome during this pandemic health crisis, I am confident of your future success, applying the engineering methods to both professional and personal problem solving. A good number of you will serve in the healthcare industry. Your knowledge and talents are much in demand and a match for the toughest of problems.
Hey everyone, congrats on graduating and welcome to the OU Young Engineering Alumni.
Congratulations and welcome to the Young Engineering Alumni. Cheers to you, you deserve this. We're so proud of you. From one OU alum to the other, Boomer Sooner.
Hey, congratulations, engineering class of 2020. Cheers to you.
Congratulations. Welcome to the Young Engineering Alumni. Cheers to you. You deserve this. We are so proud of you. From one OU alum to the other, Boomer Sooner, OU Engineering for Life.
Just want to say congratulations on meeting this milestone and congratulations on getting this far, because I know it felt like it took forever. And I know that 2020, it's been kind of super difficult, but ultimately, believe in yourself, believe in the dreams. The University of Oklahoma is a fantastic place to prepare you for the real world. So I know you can do anything. Let's just believe in ourselves and make it happen. Boomer Sooner.
Hello.
Hello, my name is John Antonio, and it's been my privilege to serve as the Interim Dean for the Gallogly College of Engineering during your final year here at OU. It would be remiss if I did not mention this unfortunate moment in human history that we are enduring due to the coronavirus pandemic. We have all been impacted by this to various degrees. Having your commencement and convocation ceremonies brought to you remotely over the internet is not how any of us wanted this to happen. It is far less than ideal. But nevertheless, here we are, and together, we're gonna make the best of this situation. Even though this is not how we envisioned your graduation ceremony, it is still very important that we celebrate the amazing goal that each of you have accomplished. It is important because it memorializes a unique and transformational milestone in each of your lives. The person you are today is a totally transformed version of the person you were when you first arrived at OU. Yes, OU and the Gallogly College of Engineering faculty and staff had a big part in that transformation. And your friends and family and loved ones also helped and supported you. But the credit really goes to each one of you, our graduates. Each of you chose to come to OU. Each of you chose to challenge yourself. Each of you chose to study what is arguably the toughest discipline on any university campus. Each of you chose to grow and transform yourselves. And most importantly, each of you chose to persevere and toil when times were tough, uncomfortable, and even stressful. I intentionally use that word toil to describe how you persevered and overcame challenges. It's not a word you hear much today, but it's a word I personally like very much. It conjures up an image of working with grit, of working hard, not giving up, and having that little bit of extra desire to complete the task. Toiling no doubt involves struggling, but it's struggling with an attitude. Toiling is a type of intentional struggling. It's struggling that you own and control. In contrast, struggling without toil, without grit or ownership can become a declining situation in which the struggle owns you instead of you owning the struggle. So the difference between what I'll call regular struggling versus toiling, it amounts to a difference in perspective, in attitude, and outlook. It's a difference in mindset, really. It's a difference of thinking and believing you will overcome the challenge. It is not thinking that the challenge will overcome you. Many of you may have heard of the notion of what's called the self-fulfilling prophecy, which in plain English boils down to this. If you think you can, or if you think you can't, either way, you'll be correct. Let me say that again. If you think you can, or if you think you can't, either way, you'll be correct. On your journey to today's graduation, I'm sure you had moments of thinking that you couldn't make it. But in the final analysis, you thought you could, more often than you thought you couldn't. Tying this back to the concept of struggling versus toiling, you basically toiled, meaning you kept a positive attitude and the right mindset more often than not. You thought that you could, and you did. Today's graduation represents just one of many great accomplishments you have already, and will in the future, achieve in your life. The process you went through to achieve this proud and happy moment represents a microcosm of the life that is ahead of you. As a closing thought, I want you to be proud of the academic performance you achieved while here at OU. You all are receiving degrees, and that is the most important factor. A few of you are actually graduating with a perfect 4.0 GPA, and we celebrate and congratulate you for making that amazing accomplishment. Others of you are graduating with something more like a 3.0 GPA, but you're not receiving 3/4 of a degree, you're receiving a complete degree, just like your 4.0 peers. And yes, others of you may have a GPA closer still to a 2.0, and yet you're not receiving half a degree. You too are receiving a complete degree just like your 4.0 peers. The point is this, all of you met the requirements of the degrees. All of you persevered and yes, toiled through the tough times, challenges, and certain courses which will remain unnamed. But nevertheless, you made it through. From this day forward, especially if you already have a job lined up, the importance of your GPA will be a less and less important part of your future. So whether you earned a 2-point-something GPA or a 3-point-something GPA, be proud of that accomplishment. Move on, look to the future. Most of all, be most proud that you graduated with an engineering or science degree from the Gallogly College of Engineering. Moving forward, don't be scared of challenges, but rather take them on knowing full well that you're prepared to tackle them with knowledge, attitude, and a positive outlook. Persevering and toiling through those challenges will lead to breakthroughs. It'll result in further growth and transformation, and ultimately equip you for even greater accomplishments in the future. Thank you, and congratulations to each and every one of you for achieving this amazing milestone.